everybody doing? It's your boy Jermaine from Shovel Nose Hogs, back with another video. And so for this video, it's going to be another morph highlight, and we're going to be talking about the toffee morph or the toffee belly. Also, it's known as that. And before we get things started, want to give an announcement. None of these pictures are mine. A lot of them, I put the credit of who produced the pictures and who produced the animals, but I didn't produce any of them. You know what I'm saying? Using these pictures are just for educational purposes. Hopefully none of them are copyrighted. But let's get down into it, man. So the toffee is actually a recessive morph. It gives kind of that brownish color animal. And as you can see, like the belly usually has some melanin. It's a T-positive albino. Not 100% sure what that means and the difference between a T-positive and a T-negative. It looks very similar to like the caramel gene, as well as like the smoke hypo and the Dutch hypo. To me, it's kind of hard for me to tell the difference between them, but all those are recessive genes. So that means that in order for this snake to visually produce this color, it has to have a copy of the gene from the mom and a copy of the gene from the dad. So let's get started with some of the combinations that you can actually see with the toffee gene. And the first one, we're going to get into the incomplete dominant gene. So the first one is going to be the anaconda, so basically the pattern reduction. And so you can see the toffeeconda, basically the animal in the previous slide, but with a reduced pattern. I really like the picture of the animal on the right-hand side. It has a pattern similar to the new snake that I got. I like how it's kind of faded out, has that clean white background. All right, so let's bump it up a step more. When we have two copies of the anaconda gene, one from the mom, one from the dad, you get the super form, and this is where you have the toffee superconda, also known as the candy. It looks very similar to the superconda albino, but as you can see, it's kind of that light brown color. It's a very pretty snake, and then the head pattern is that light brown color. But this is a very cool looking superconda hognose snake. All right, so now let's get into the second type of incomplete dominant gene in hognose snakes, and this is going to be the Arctic gene. So basically, it kind of gives a lot of contrast between the pattern as well as the background. And usually the outline of the pattern is highlighted in black or melanin, or it has little flakes of melanin around the pattern. So all these pictures that I'm going to show you with the Arctic toffee are going to be from Jeff at JMG Reptiles. He's the one that discovered the Arctic gene, and he has a lot of quality Arctic toffee examples. So you can see right here, the one on the left-hand side and the one on the right-hand side, they look pretty different, but you can see that they both have the characteristics of that Arctic gene. As you can see, a big contrast between the pattern and the background, and then especially on the right, the one on the left-hand side, you can see little flakes of that darker pigment around the pattern. All right, and so next up, we're going to add in the other incomplete dominant gene, which is the conda. So basically the Arctic toffee with a reduced pattern. As you can see, these are very good examples of them. And the one on the left-hand side actually looks very similar to the toffee super Arctic. But this one, Jeff had it labeled as just the toffee Arctic conda. All right, so now let's see what we get when we mix the toffee with the super Arctic version of the Arctic gene. And we get this right here. And you've probably already seen this slide from my Super Arctic presentation. And so it's even more of a contrast between the background and the pattern. And then you see those striking jet black eyes, because the pupil and the iris are going to be both black. And so this is a very pretty animal, the Super Arctic toffee. All right. And so the next one is going to be a little different, man. We're going to talk about some dominant genes. And right now I'm actually working on a presentation where I go over the genetics of hognoses. So we're going to be talking about the dominant gene, codominant, what's the difference between a codominant and an incomplete dominant, as well as recessive. using pundit squares and everything like that. So I'm not going to really cover the dominant genes in this video. But this first one we're going to talk about is the RBE pastel mixed with the toffee. So the RBE pastel is basically a color enhancement. So it actually makes the snake's pattern pop out more, makes it brighter. And usually when a snake has this gene right here, the RBE pastel, the snakes get more vibrant as they age. So when you mix these two together, you get what's called a vanilla cherry. And I have the regular version as well as the Conda version as examples. And you can really see how bright it gets with the Conda. So we'll go back to the previous slide. You can see what the regular toffee looks like. And then when you add in that RBE pastel gene, it really makes the pattern a lot lighter. All right, so next we're gonna go into another dominant gene, and we're gonna go into the Lemon Ghost, one of my favorite morphs of hog noses. I don't know why I don't have one in my collection. I've actually passed on it twice at Reptile Expos, and I always regret it, but it's soon I will have one in my collection. The Lemon Ghost is a lime bred trait that was produced by Jeff at JMG Hog Noses. And what happens when you combine the Lemon Ghost and the toffee? You get this right here, man. One of the prettiest hog nose snakes out there. Especially look at this picture on the left hand side produced by Jeff. That is one of the prettiest hog noses I've ever seen, man. That color, that orange and yellow, it's just very unique. I've never seen a hog nose look like that. At the Daytona Reptile Expo, I actually saw a toffee Lemon Ghost that looked just like the one on the right-hand side. So I think the one on the right-hand side is what they generally look like. These are very yellow, greenish animals. I think they're a lot more yellow than a Lemon Ghost. And Lemon Ghost actually gets more yellow as it ages. So these are definitely very good looking snakes. And definitely something that I hope to have in my collection one day. All right, so now let's get into the recessive genes mixed with toffee. The first one we're going to talk about is the albino. So what happens when you mix the albino and the toffee together? You get what's called a toffee glow. Basically a light yellow animal. And it actually looks very similar to the Arctic albino. So if you don't know what the Arctic albino is, that's what my snake Noodle is. He's a yellow snake. And when I saw pictures of this, that's the first thing I thought of. So this is a toffee glow, basically a yellow snake. All right, the next recessive gene is going to be when you mix Exanthic with toffee. And if you saw my Exanthic video, you've already seen what this is. And when you mix those two together, you get what's called a toxic. So basically a grayish animal. On the left-hand side, I just have a regular toxic, and then on the right-hand side, I have the toxic Conda, so the toxic with a reduced pattern. And then once you get the toxic with two copies of the Conda gene, you get what's called a toxic superconda. And like I said in my Exanthic video, I think this snake right here is the best-looking superconda morph out there right now. I don't know if it's just how pretty the picture is or just how pretty the snake is. I think it looks better than the snow supercondas, the albino supercondas, all that. The toxic supercondas. That's where I think a lot of people should be headed, right there. All right, so now let's get into the next recessive gene. And this is a gene that I think I've included it one time, and it's the Evans Hypo. It looks very similar to the toffee. They both have that brownish color, but when you mix these two together, you get a snake called the Ignition. And I don't think a lot of people have produced this animal. I had a hard time finding pictures of it, but it's like a pinkish looking snake. It's a lot of pink looking hognose snakes. But yeah, this is very unique, and I don't think a lot of people even had this or even produced this animal yet. All right, so let's get into the next recessive gene. And we're gonna add toffee belly to lavender. And if you've seen my lavender video, I've already showed you these slides. And so this is another rare animal. This is the only picture that I can find of the combination. On the left-hand side, you have a low expression lavender. On the far right-hand side, you have a toffee. And then in the middle, you have the lavender toffee combination. This picture right here, the lavender toffee, to me, it just looks like a regular lavender. So I'm guessing if you have a better lavender, a lavender that has more of that purple expression, you may get a different color animal when you combine the lavender and Toffee Belly. But like I say, this is the only picture that I can find of the two combined. All right, the next recessive gene we're gonna talk about, and the last one is gonna be what happens when you add sable to the Toffee. And if you watch my sable video, you already seen this. And this is one of the prettiest snakes out there. Definitely something, if you're jumping into the sable gene, you may wanna, you know what I'm saying, invest in this project. And it is called the Muay Thai. I think that's how you pronounce it. And see, you can see on the right-hand side, I just have the regular Muay Thai. And then on the left-hand side, I have the regular Muay Thai. And then on the right-hand side, we have the Muay Thai Conda with just a reduced pattern. And so what happens when you have the Muay Thai and you have two copies of the Conda gene? You get the Muay Thai Super Conda right here. So you can see a good picture on the left-hand side. And then on the right-hand side, shout out to Jason Taylor. He has a good picture comparing and contrasting the difference between a Toffee Super Conda and a Muay Thai Super Conda. So you can see on the left-hand side is the Toffee, and then right next to it on the right-hand side is the Muay Thai. So yeah, man, this is, you know what I'm saying, this is a Toffee is a really good morph, and I didn't realize how much has been mixed with other morphs until I started doing research on this video. And it's actually more combinations that I didn't include on this PowerPoint, basically because I couldn't find the pictures online. And so things like the Toffee Pistachio, the Toffee Shadow, and things like that. But if you're interested in seeing some of those other combinations and you want pictures, man, I really recommend this book right here, if you can kind of see it with the glare, by Kevin Rhodes, Morph Guide and Natural History of the Western Hognose Snake. He has whole bunch of pictures of different morphs. I always use this book as a reference to make sure that I'm getting all the morph combinations that there are out there right now so I can put them in my videos. But yeah, man, shout out to all my new subscribers, everybody that likes my videos, comments, all the people that have been with me from the beginning. I really appreciate the support. And let me know what other kind of morphs y'all want me to cover in future videos. And I have a lot more videos and ideas that I'm going to come up with in the future. So appreciate y'all for watching this video, and I'll see y'all next time.